Hi, my name is Taiki and welcome to Shishigoat. In this video, I talk about Japanese language, Japanese culture, and how to understand anime without subtitles, and sometimes interviews like this. So if you're interested in those things, please hit that subscribe button and hit that notification bell as well. So today's video is going to be in French, which I want to practice. So I will put the subtitles in here to te présenter.
Oui. Alors, je m'appelle Pearl, j'ai 26 ans et je viens de France. Et ça fait maintenant 2 ans et demi que j'habite au Japon.
Pourquoi t'es venue au Japon?
Alors, bon, depuis toute petite, j'aime le Japon.
Oui.
Et mon rêve, c'était de vivre au Japon.
Ok. Alors, quelle était l'image du Japon avant d'arriver au Japon?
Pour moi, le Japon était un pays très respectueux,
oui.
Très distant dans le sens entre personnes, pas tactile. Et c'était un très très beau pays avec des très très beaux paysages.
But in France too, you know, I've seen a lot of photos of French nature and I found them very beautiful too.
Yeah, that's true. But it was like almost people know Japan with anime and manga.
Mm.
And recently I watched a video. They made a difference between anime and true
reality.
Yeah, and it was exactly the same. That's why it makes me like, wow, in France we don't do this kind of animation, you know?
Yeah.
And that's why it was, it's same beautiful than anime. That's why I say, like, wow, I want to go there and live like anime life.
Okay. C'est différent que l'image avant d'arriver.
Oui et non. Les paysages sont aussi beaux que ce que j'imaginais. Après, je sais pas si le fait d'être venu à Osaka, les Japonais sont très amicales. Très tactile, vont te faire des câlins facilement.
Ah, ça c'est différent.
Oui, oui. Osaka, je pense, au Takajin.
Oui.
Ils sont très friendly, amical. Okay. Du coup, l'image est complètement différente.
How do you say culture shock in French?
Choc culturel.
Choc culturel.
Culturel. C'est la vie active des Japonais.
Ok.
En France, je vois mes amis toutes les semaines. Et au Japon, il faut regarder l'emploi du temps, le planning.
Oui.
Là, c'est, je suis libre le mois prochain. Je fais, what? Et, like, I'm free the next month. Ça, c'est like, wait, what?
C'est très, très long. Jusqu'à les prochaines fois.
Oui.
Ah, ok. Ça, c'est le plus grand choc culturel.
Du coup, c'est difficile de se faire des amis japonais.
Okay.
Car on passe pas beaucoup de temps ensemble. C'est dur de se connaître, apprendre à se connaître. Premièrement, il y a la langue qui peut être difficile si on ne parle pas anglais ou japonais. En France, mes amis, je les vois tout le temps, donc je peux parler avec eux, j'ai toujours... J'apprends plein de trucs. Une fois par mois, ça devient un étranger à chaque fois. J'oublie de quoi on a parlé un mois avant, du coup, on ne peut pas reparler.
So, your friends travel a lot to overseas, too.
Un étranger à chaque fois.
So your friends travel a lot to.
In France, we see very so many times. Like we are free like every weekend.
But in Japan, people are busy. All the time.
In Japan, like if I meet people every one time per month, it starts to be like a stranger again because. A friend, you speak with them, and the next week we speak again about like last week or the last party. But if you make a party and you see your friend 1 month after, you will don't talk about that, you know, like too late. It was like you forgot already the party or you forgot already about what we talk. Choc culturel, j'en ai un deuxième. Oui. Ça reste encore le respect des Japonais.
Respect. Respect.
Yeah. Oh. Quand on prend le métro, les lignes.
Oui.
En France ou n'importe où, on pousse et on rentre pour s'asseoir. Au Japon, c'est on attend et.
C'est bon choc culturel. Ok. Qu'est-ce que tu aimes à Japon?
Ce que j'aime, bah, c'est tout.
Oui,
c'est tout. Facile. Okay. La culture japonaise.
Oui.
Je veux en apprendre plus sur leur façon de vivre, comment ils pensent entre eux. Puis bah, les paysages, comme j'avais dit.
Le culture, par exemple, le cul, le bel cul, en train. Oui.
La culture, c'est leur façon, pourquoi ils sont respectueux, pourquoi ils sont serviables, pourquoi, si, gentils, très très gentils. Oui. Après, ça va être aussi la culture, ça va être la cérémonie du thé, les sports. J'apprends beaucoup sur la mentalité des Japonais via mon sport.
Oui. Elle fait du sport.
Yaido.
Alors, qu'est-ce que tu n'aimes pas au Japon?
Ça va être encore sur la mentalité japonaise. Tatemae.
Tatemae. Ah, c'est compliqué, oui.
Très dur à comprendre et accepter. Je le traduirais comme... Les Japonais préfèrent dire un mensonge qui fait plaisir qu'une vérité qui blesse. Par exemple, quand je parle avec des Japonais, je leur dis genre Konnichiwa, Watashiwa, Paju des. Et les Japonais vont dire genre Waouh, Mucha Jojo, Jozo, Jozo, Nihon. Et j'ai juste dit bonjour, je m'appelle Peur. Je ne parle pas bien japonais.
Je peux dire ça en français aussi.
Ne fais pas. Ça m'énerve.
Oui.
Ça me met en colère.
Ok.
Parce que c'est faux. Je ne parle pas bien. Enfin, I think for French people, if you say to French people, you speak very well Japanese, with this small sentence, you will take like too much pride and you say, oh yes, I speak Japanese. I don't need to learn more now because I speak well. People told me that.
Ensuite, qu'est-ce que les plus grandes difficultés en Japon?
La langue.
La langue.
Parce que sans le japonais, on ne peut pas rentrer dans la population japonaise. On sera toujours des étrangers. On ne peut pas parler. Even if you speak Japanese, it will not be perfectly. And Japanese people, they will think you don't speak Japanese and they don't, you know, make it distant. That's a big challenge to be inside to the Japanese culture and life, I guess, if you don't speak the language.
But there are many, you know, the numbers of people who can speak English in Japan is very increasing, so.
Yeah, of course.
So, if you're planning on moving to Japan, I'm pretty sure there will be more places to speak English so you can, you know, feel comfortable. But if you want to speak, you know, if you want to learn Japanese, what you have to do is, you know, blend in with those Japanese people and trying to use Japanese words that you know. And why am I speaking English?
Okay,
so easier, but yeah. C'est très important de parler en japonais si tu veux prendre le japonais.
Pratiquer énormément.
Pratiquer en japonais aussi, oui.
C'est pour ça que je vais dans des bars où il n'y a que des japonais. Je me retrouve la seule étrangère. Personne parle anglais.
Oui.
Et je passe de très très bonnes soirées avec mon petit japonais que j'ai.
Oui. Alors, t'inquiète pas, fais des efforts en japonais.
Pour être honnête, genre... Il y a 2 ans, quand je suis arrivée au Japon, je parlais ni anglais ni japonais. Et c'est à force de pratiquer et de m'entourer de j'ai beaucoup d'amis français, mais de m'entourer aussi beaucoup de japonais, d'étrangers, qui m'a permis d'apprendre la langue, ces deux langues, assez rapidement.
Mmh. Ensuite, recommandes-tu venir au Japon?
Oh oui, bien sûr.
Ouais.
Enfin, étant mon pays préféré, forcément, je oui. veux que les gens apprennent plus sur la culture japonaise. Il faut savoir que la culture japonaise est très différente de toutes les autres cultures, surtout mmh. de la France ou des États-Unis, de l'Europe.
Mmh.
Et un changement radical, c'est toujours très intéressant. Et au Japon, c'est un changement de culture, mais positif.
Mmh, mmh.
J'ai pas trouvé de choses négatives par rapport à la culture française. À part qu'il n'y a pas de saucisson et de pain. Mais bon, ça, Japanese culture is very different to our culture, but
right.
positive way. Mmh. Like, every time it's like good food. Good mind,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Good hobbies.
Like sushi, respecting other people.
The temple.
Or, temples,
shrine,
yeah.
Yeah, like everything is different, the positive. Mm-hmm. The negative you will don't see if you're just visiting, I think. It's only
right.
when you go very deep to the Japanese culture you will.
Right, right.
But it's still nothing for me. You know?
Qu'est-ce que le plus difficile dans la langue japonaise?
Tout et rien. Le plus okay. difficile, ça va être la lecture et l'écrit.
Oui.
Les trois alphabets, c'est très
oui,
dur.
Oui, 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 oui.
Et la prononciation, c'est facile. C'est former les phrases, mm-hmm. c'est différent de français.
Ok, ok.
C'est
the
sujet,
placement. Of... Right, right, right.
Et verbe
so,
à la
oui,
fin.
Oui, 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 oui.
Et du coup, j'ai du mal à faire mes phrases en japonais, mettre les particules, savoir laquelle, pour quel mot, comment, quand on met aussi deux
oui,
verbes
oui.
en même temps.
Oui, oui, oui.
Et puis, ils n'ont pas de futur. Non, de pas, ouais. Vous n'avez pas de futur.
Futur tense. Mm. Tense. Or, yeah.
Oui, futur. Futur, simplement.
Futur.
Vous n'avez pas de futur.
Like subject, verb, object, but rather than, you know, in Japanese, going to be. Object, there is no subject,
subject
you know, there is no even subject in
Nene.
Japanese, you know, there is, but...
Or most time don't use.
Right, we tend to exclude pronouns, you know, like I, we don't really say I or anata, you know, you.
That's why after we don't know if you speak about
right,
yourself
yeah.
or about myself.
Yes, yes. And that's what happens in Japanese conversation too, you know, someone says, do you have it? But we don't say you, so who are you asking? You know, that kind of situation happens a lot in Japanese mm-hmm. too, even among Japanese people. So I don't know why Japanese excluded pronouns, you know, it's very difficult. And the particles, like, by example, wa.
Watashi wa.
Watashi wa.
Watashi ga.
Watashi ga.
Watashi no.
Watashi no.
Watashi mo.
Watashi mo. Yeah.
Watashi ni.
Watashi ni.
Yukimo.
Watashi ni. So give that to me.
Oh.
Watashi ni kudasai.
Oh, yes. Because ni, it's like.
Right.
You go somewhere but to.
Right, right, right,
to,
right,
ah.
right, right. Ensuite, est-il facile de travailler au Japon si l'on ne parle pas japonais?
Si on travaille dans une entreprise étrangère.
Mm-hmm.
La plupart du temps, l'anglais va suffire.
Mm-hmm.
Après, si on veut travailler dans une entreprise japonaise, si c'est pas pour la traduction ou
oui.
tout ce qui est commercial, il faudra forcément savoir parler japonais. Après, moi, j'ai eu de la chance de travailler dans des bars,
mm-hmm.
dans des bars d'étrangers, donc ce qui fait que j'avais surtout besoin de parler anglais et un petit peu japonais. Que si je parlais pas japonais, il y avait toujours quelqu'un pour m'aider. Ou
okay.
les japonais eux-mêmes parlaient anglais, donc... mais pour une vraie entreprise, c'est vrai que c'est plus difficile si on n'a pas...
Okay.
Même juste pour postuler. If no. you want to work at the company, even if you need someone speak English,
right.
they will ask you, like, during the job interview, you maybe they will do that in Japanese. And if you don't have a Japanese enough, maybe they will don't take you, even if for the English
okay.
ask. I want to work here. Give the resume and say I want to work here. Oh, on internet.
Ah, okay. So like a submitting form.
Yeah.
For a job interviewing.
Yes.
So you type in your Japanese proficiency level there, and some, you know, let's say you want to be working in a restaurant, and some restaurants might not take you if. After looking at your Japanese proficiency level, is that what you said?
Yeah.
Okay.
I have some friends, they work like only in English, but during the job interview, because it was a Japanese company,
right.
it was only in Japanese.
So it's gonna be very, very difficult.
Yes.
If you can't speak Japanese there.
Like
Japanese.
If you work, I'm working at the bar.
Right.
And it was foreigner bar. That's why like the customers was half Japanese, half foreigner. That's why even if I didn't speak Japanese enough or speak with customers, my coworker was able to help me with the Japanese. Or sometimes the customer can speak English too. That's why it was like, you can speak English. It helped me so much.
If you choose some like Irish pubs, for example, bartenders I've met, you know, they only knew about like konnichiwa, genki desu ka, some very basic words, so it's not gonna be always necessary.
Yeah, that's like the number, like almost my coworker couldn't speak Japanese, but enough for say hello and thank you and say the price, and that's it.
But if you want to work in an actual company, right, you want to work in an actual Japanese company, the Japanese speaking proficiency is going to be a requirement. What would be your suggestion to people who want to work in Japan? Like
the easier it will be, like the restoration and bar, I think.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Because even Japanese people don't want to work there. I know so many foreigners, they work in the izakaya. It means like only Japanese boss and Japanese customers, even if they cannot speak Japanese perfectly. But enough for the work, that's okay.
Did you go to a language school in Japan? Like first arrive?
I never been to Japanese school.
She never been to a language school. How did you learn Japanese so well? You know, you must have been very struggling when first came.
10 years ago, I have night lesson in French.
Okay.
But because I was young, I didn't take care, and I would go there for speak with my friend and listen some Japanese, but when I was finished, I would just remember the hiragana and the presentation easy one, like my name is, hello, the number, only where is this, what is it, only in this I know it. That way like, very basic when I came to Japan. But after, I just learned with my customers at bar, with when I met Japanese people can speak English, or French people, they can speak Japanese. I ask them every time some word, like, I heard this word so many times, what does it mean? And they ask me, or how did you say that, or what he said? And it was explained, and I just learned like this.
That's very meaningful to you guys.
Yeah, actually,
you know, it can save you a lot of money.
They have so many applications on phone or book. You can help you with this. Me, I never did. And I think if I was did for 2 years, my Japanese can be improved so quickly. Actually, I never use books, but I know everyone say like Mina no Nihongo.
Mina no Nihongo.
This one is very good, but everything is white in Japanese. That's
right.
Can be a little difficult. And in France, I was trying to learn Japanese with le manga, en, le japonais en manga. It's like, but you learn so many words from anime. It's like not perfect word for speak.
You know, from Naruto. Naruto speaks, you know, he adds dattebayo at the end, which nobody, you know, nobody speaks that way in real life, but
Shannaro.
Sakura. Sakura. Sasuke is going to be Usura Tonkachi, you know. Well, if you're not anime fan, you just don't forget about this part, you know. So what application do you recommend?
Memories, but it's not French still, you know.
Ah, okay. So it's a French application.
Yeah.
Application. So it's going to be...
It's a what in French.
Okay, so memories.
Memories, and I think like Babel? You have to pay, but I think it's a very good one.
Well, I'll include that in the description below, okay? What I use also is called HelloTalk, which allows you to talk in the target language. So thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed watching. And if you did, definitely give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And please don't forget to push the notification bell so you won't miss my contents. I'll see you in the next video. Sayonara.
Bye.
Bye. Au revoir.
Au revoir.